Hello. So today I'm doing a video called The Best and Worst Books Written by Rock Musicians, because I have read quite a few in my time. So I just wanted to say the best and worst ones, and then say basically my rating system for the best and worst ones, because like I said, I did read a lot of them, and I am working my way through basically all of them. So I'm just gonna start with the ones I read, obviously. So firstly, obviously, I got this one, which is Adrenalized by Phil Collins. And everybody should know, because Def Leppard is one of the best bands. So for me, this book, it wasn't that bad, considering how the rest of the books are. It's not that bad. Like, it's the not typical book, but it's the first book, I think. I think this is the first one written by anybody in Def Leppard, which I guess makes it special. And, I like this book. It's not too bad. I mean, it has a couple of parts in it that I'm like, eh. Like, a couple parts, like, that are like, ew. And basically the parts I'm saying ew to are the parts about them being, like, with girls and things like that. Like, that's not something you need to say in great detail in your book. You don't need to say that. It's like, you don't need to use that word, because now I have a visual in my brain and I did not want to see that. So, no. So, but for this book, I would give it a rating of 3.5 stars, because I mean, meh. But I think you would have to like Phil Collins to like this book, because I mean, if you don't really like him, then you might be like, meh, to the book. But to me, it's a good book, so 3.5 out of 5 stars, because I like Def Leppard, so he gets 3.5. Another book I read, some of them are digital, which is what I forgot to say, was the book How to Be a Man and Other Illusions, which is a Duff McKagan book, which I don't know if you can see, but it says I read it in 6 hours and 29 minutes. Obviously, it's called How to Be a Man. So obviously, it's a manly manual book. But what I liked about it is, even though it's directed supposedly towards men, like, it could be for anybody, which is what I liked about it. But it's not one of those hideous books that's like, oh, women are this, women are that. It's a good book. And it's not, like, hideous, like I said. And I like it because in the section where he mentions the 100 albums that everybody should listen to, which is something I would do, because I was like, I was shocked how much I relate to this book, because there's a lot of stuff in it that I said, hey, I would do that. But anyways, in the top 100 albums, he mentions the album Diamond Dogs by David Bowie, which if you watch my YouTube channel a lot, you'll know is my favorite David Bowie album. And I just thought that was really nice to have that in there. So for the book How to Be a Man and Other Illusions, I would give it a 4.5, because I think it's really good. So, and I think most people, yeah, I would recommend that book to read. Like the Phil Collins one, it's, I'm not saying I wouldn't recommend it, but like I said, if you don't like Def Leppard all that much, or you don't really care just to read a typical story, then it's So, yeah. How to Be a Man and Other Illusions is a 4.5 from me. The next one is Dancing with Myself from Billy Idol. Oh, I see it's clear, baby. And the problem with this book is there's so much to dislike about this book, and it's like, why? It's like I really wanted to like this book, because obviously I like Billy Idol, and I really wanted to like this book, but it's just a no. on so many levels. From the literal ignorance of Billy Idol, and it's like he's this old and he still doesn't realize how bad that sounds. Like, half the stuff he says in the book, I'm like, do you not realize what you sound like saying this? Do you not? It's just like, you can't say stuff like that. And it's, you can, because I mean, free country, free world, you can do what you want and say what you want. But I'm just like, you just sound so ignorant and stupid. And I just can't. So this book gets a 2, well, not even a 2 stars. It gets a 0.5 star. For being that bad. And because the way he talks about, like, if I was a girl, I would feel this and that and this and that from my songs. And I'm like, no, you do not have the songs that make those things occur. Like, stop. If you think you're that amazing, then you need to reevaluate your whole entire, like, that's what I was gonna say. Billy Idol seems like one of those people, like, reading this book, even though your book can make you seem like sometime or whatever, but it just seems like one of those people that just thinks they're way more amazing than they actually are, and you're like, please stop. But I still like Billy Idol, despite reading this steaming lump of trash known as book. So, oh well. But yes, that gets 0.5 star because it was not that amazing. The next book I had was this book, which is called My Appetite for Destruction, which is a Steven Adler book. And I was going to read this a couple years back, but instead of this book, I got this book, which was the How Can It Be a Rock and Roll Diary by Ronnie Wood, which is obviously just his little diary from the 60s that he made. So instead of buying this book a few years ago, I bought that book. Well, I didn't buy that book, but I got that book for Christmas instead of this one. And the thing I was going to say is, I liked most of this book. And this would have been a 5 out of 5 book, 5 out of 5 stars book, if it wasn't for the fact that he tried to justify John Lennon's usage of a certain word in a certain song, and I'm like, I really wanted to like you, but you had to do that. You just had to go there. And like, I already mentioned my problem with John Lennon in a different video, so I don't really want to rehash that, but I'll just put like the clip of what was my problem with this. And if you know John Lennon or you know this book, then you'll know what I'm talking about. And if you agree with any of them, then it's like, why? Like, this is a level of, I don't even know the word, but this is a level of incomprehensible buffoonery that I cannot.
And then luckily for me, because a lot of stations were saying, well, we're not going to play this because it says nigger and a white man shouldn't say it, though all my black friends feel I have quite a right to say it because they understand it. And then, strangely enough, the chairman of the Black Caucus, that great guy, Congressman Ron Dellums, Democrat California, says here, he came out with this, which is fantastic. If you define niggers as someone whose lifestyle is defined by others, whose opportunities are defined by others, whose role in society is defined by others, then good news, you don't have to be black to be a nigger in this society. Most of the people in America are niggers.
You know what you are? I pity you, because you know what you are? You're an ignorant, racist, unfair motherfucker. It's unjust!
But the rest of the book is really good, and if it wasn't for that, then I would give it 5 stars, but because of that, it gets bumped all the way down to 2.5 stars simply because of that defense of John Lennon and that defense of Axl Rose, because it doesn't give you justification. Like, please stop. No. So that gives this 2.5 stars, but other than that, it is a 10 out of 10, 5 out of 5 star book, but that part is no. Oh, and besides all the detailed accounts of how do you say? I don't want to say this word, but the detailed accounts of him being with women, which is really disturbing, because like I said, that's something you write if you want to write your own personal porno book collection. Like, nobody else wants to hear that. Like, for future book writers, don't write stuff like that in your books, because nobody wants to hear it, okay? I know 50 Shades of Grey is like a popular book, but most of the population doesn't want to read stuff like that, so cut it out. So anyway, that gives this a 2.5, but I think you should read it other than that fact. So, and there's a lot of ignorant stuff in the book, but other than that fact, well, actually, that part doesn't matter. So, anyways, other than that fact, you should read this book because it's good. But, moving on. The next book is how can it be a Rock and Roll Diary from Ronnie Wood? Younger. He wrote this in 1965, I believe, and I was like, I really, really like this book. It's cute. It's a little diary, and you know, it has the cover that comes off and it's just like that, and it shows that it's from 1965, official and whatnot. It's falling apart because I keep flinging it in the closet. Anyways, I think it's good, this little book. It's just him. I like it because it's, I forget how old he's supposed to be in 1965. I forget. I haven't read this in like 2 years. But basically, it's just him telling his whole entire life throughout the year of 1965. And I really, really loved. I really, really like that. Because there's not too many, there's no graphic content that is like him being with this lady and this lady and this lady. Like, that type of stuff is so much, so disturbing. It's like I have to skim through the book like, ugh, Jesus. So I like that this book didn't have that in there. So that's what this book, if I had to rate it, it would get a 4.5 because it is good, really good. So I like it, and that's why it's a 4.5. The next book was this book, which is, I think, called Slash by Slash. Come on, be a little young, but honey, I can die. Anthony Boza or Baza, but I don't know if it's called Slash, like you don't know the title, but I mean, it was a good book. It was just him talking about, like, that's what I forgot to mention, the Steven Adler book and the Slash book and the book called It's So Easy and Other Lies, which I'll get to in a minute. The thing about this is, if you watch The Most Dangerous Band in the World, then you watch the movie It's So Easy and Other Lies, please don't, because no, that movie is a negative 0 stars. And then you read the book It's So Easy and Other Lies, but don't watch the movie because your ears will be bleeding, like, no. So anyways, if you watch the movie It's So Easy and Other Lies, watch The Most Dangerous Band in the World, read My Appetite for Destruction, read the book Slash, and read, It's So Easy in Other Lives. You heard the same story from like 8 different perspectives. So I'm saying just prepare yourself for hearing the same story, but from each person's perspective, which I like. I personally like that about the books from the fellow band members of Guns N' Roses. So I like that because you get everybody else's thought, take, and perspective on the situation. Now, reading the book on Slash, I said I liked it too because there was a couple of parts where he was talking about being with different girls, whatever, whatever. But for the most part, it had a coherent story and it just flows along nicely. So you see, this book, not that any of these you can really just read out loud, but I mean, for the most part, this book is the least, why, of the rest of the books, because the rest of the books, they have some of them have a hinge to it. But this one is good. I would read it again, I would say. So for the Slash book, I would give him a 5 out of 5 because it was actually decent. The next book is My Life with Bowie by Woody Woodmansey. I mean, I kind of, sort of, everybody was calling this book trash before it ever even came out. And I was like, can we wait for it to come out before we judge it being trash? And then I read it. It is trash. So please, spare yourself and the world with this book. Because we're not even going to bother talking about how much stuff in this book makes it trash. It's just like... And it's not even that he's talking about David Bowie or anything like that. It's just like some of the stuff... It's his personality that comes through the book. And it's like, I feel like, why are you writing this with an attitude? Like, he seems like a crusty person. And he may be nicer in real life, but this book was written with an attitude. And I'm like, why do you have an attitude at me? I didn't do anything to you. And I'm like, I didn't do anything. So why do you have an attitude, sir? Remove your attitude. So yes, this book is trash simply for attitude alone. So, no. The next book is 18 in Life on Skid Row by Sebastian Bach. And this book is a 10 out of 10 and a 5 out of 5 stars. It's just really good. This is a fun book, is what I would say. This is a fun read. It's big like that. And I would say this book has 0% ignorance, 0% parts that make me be like, gouge my eyes out. And it's just such a nice book. You can like just change up a couple of the curse words in there and you can read this book. And I think it's a good time book. You can read it and you'll have fun with this book. And I really, really like it because, I don't know, it's just like a book you can read and start laughing along with as you read it. And it's really good when you read it. And I think everybody should read it because it's really, really good. Regardless of if you like Skid Row or not, I think you should read this book because it's really good. And now, I'm not the best person in the world at giving reviews of like, oh, this part, this part, this part, and saying like my favorite quotes from the books because my brain barely functions as it is, so no. But I basically did like it, so it gets a 5 out of 5, like I said, 5 out of 5, 10 out of 10. The next book is It's So Easy and Other Lies by Duff McKagan. This is another digital one. I don't know how long it took to read this, but this book was good. There wasn't too many first parts. There wasn't too much ignorance in it. There was actually none, I don't think. I don't think there was any. And that's a really, really nice thing to see in the book. So because of that, I give this book a 4.5. I mean, I don't know, unless you've been like through that situation or whatever, I'm not one of those people that be's like, oh my god, I cried reading this. Or one of those people that be's like, it's so inspirational. 1-1-1. Like, no, I'm not one of those people, but it's a good book. And I would say it's a nice look at people and the world and things like that. And it's nice to see, not nice to see, but I mean, and that's why I should get this Stephen Adler book back out too, because reading the Stephen Adler book, there's a couple things in there that I was like, oh, people have said stuff like that, or this has happened to me. And it's nice to see with the Stephen Adler book and the Duff McKagan book that people have had the same type of universal experiences in and out their lives, which is nice to see, basically, which is what I wanted to say. So that's why I liked It's So Easy and Other Lies, because it's a really, really good book. And I give it a 4 out of 5, like I said. I'm just going to quickly go through the list of ones to read, ones not to read. You should read 18 in Life. You should read this. You should read My Appetite for Destruction. You should read it. You should read It's So Easy and Other Lies. You should read The Slash Book. And you should read How Can It Be a Rock and Roll Diary, which is by Ronnie Wood. The rest you can leave alone and delete from your brain because no. So, I thank you for watching and I will see you in the next video.